Now, my question is, in this setup, then what's the total width of the region where I get the interference pattern? What is AB? What is the distance between the two sources? What is D? Remember, here S dash acts as the second source, because the light waves which hit the screen after reflection from the mirror seem to come from S dash. Okay, so let's find out. You see that the first source, that is this directly hitting, let's say this has a phase of phi 1. The second source, that is here, the light waves that which seem to come from S dash actually is coming from the reflection. Now, you know that when a light wave undergoes a reflection, there is a phase change of phi. Now, why that happens? Let's understand that. The proof of that is beyond the scope of this chapter, but let's draw an analogy with waves. You know that we had discussed that when we have a wave, when we have a string tied on this surface, tightly tied on the surface, and we give a momentary push like this, then what happens? This push travels like this, and when it returns the push, it comes inverted like this. So this actually, after hitting the hard surface, gets reflected and undergoes a phase change of pi, because it's completely inverted. Similarly, but if we have something like this, and we have a loose end, and we have a string like this, and now you give a push, after reflection, the disturbance comes similar to like this one. There is no phase change. So, in case of waves, you saw that when the wave gets reflected from a hard surface, which is like this, tight, we get a phase change of pi, and when the wave gets reflected from a loose surface, then there's no phase change of pi. Okay? Now, for light waves, you can draw a similar analogy. The analogy is that when light waves, let's say this medium has a refractive index n1, this medium has a refractive index n2. When light waves strikes the medium or the surface separating two medium, if n2 has a refractive index greater than n1, then the light waves will get a phase change of pi. If n2 is lighter medium than n1, then there is no phase change of pi. The phase change is zero. Okay? So that's why in this case we had a mirror like this, we had a source, this was my first source, and this was my virtual second source. Okay, this distance was B, this distance was C, and this whole distance, let's say it has D, and this distance, let's say, is small d. So my question was, I asked you to find D, and this distance AB. Okay. Now before we do that, let's find the condition for interference in this setup. So as I said, that if this source has a phase of phi 1, this reflected source, because of a phase change of pi here, has a phase change of phi 1 plus pi, right? Because of this reflection. So, in my original equation, that was 2 pi by lambda del x plus del phi source is equal to the phase difference del phi. This quantity now is pi. So I get 2 pi by lambda delta x plus pi is equal to del phi. Now for constructive interference, this should be equal to 2k pi, right? So from here I get that 2 pi by lambda del x, it should be equal to 2k minus 1 pi. or delta x should be equal to 2k minus 1 pi. Okay. Now, here you see that this was the case of destructive interference in case this is 2k minus 1 lambda. Now, you can see here that this was the case of destructive interference. This final equation was the case of destructive interference in case of Young's double slit experiment. But now, here we have constructive interference. This gives constructive interference in this case. Similarly, if you want to find the condition for destructive interference, this should be equal to 2k plus 1 pi, or you will get delta x by lambda should be equal to 2k, or delta x should be equal to 2k lambda. So, here you see that the condition for destructive interference is that the path difference should be equal to 2k pi, and the condition for constructive interference is that the path difference should be a multiple of, here we have a term of 2 also. So, here it comes as delta x is equal to k minus half times lambda. So, here the condition is delta x should be equal to an odd integral multiple of lambda by 2. So, you can see that the conditions for constructive and destructive interference has got interchanged in this case compared to the Young's double slit experiment. This happens because in this case, we have a phase difference of pi within the source itself. Okay. So, that's why the constructive and interference and destructive interference conditions have got interchanged. Also, the other difference in case of Lloyd single mirror is that we don't get an overall interference pattern throughout the screen. We get an interference pattern only in this small portion where both the light waves strike the screen. Okay. So, now I come back to the task I have given you. The task to find out the difference between the slits, the distance between the sources and the screen, and the total width of the fringes. So, let's do that. My this height was A. So, obviously, you can say that distance between the slits is 2A. What is capital D? It's just B plus C plus this distance, which may be any distance, and what is the total width of these fringes? To find that, we have to do some geometry. Let's take first this triangle. This triangle I can write A by B is equal to OA by this distance, which is equal to D minus B. And now if I take this triangle, I can write A by B plus C is equal to OB divided by D minus B plus C. Now, what is AB? AB is basically OA minus OB, right? If you find the difference of OA and OB, you'll get the total width as ACD divided by B plus C. Okay? Okay. Now, let's take another example, that is the Fresnel's double mirror, where again we get an interference pattern with two mirrors and a single source. So, I guess this setup is clear. Here we get interference pattern only in this portion, and the condition for constructive interference and destructive interference are interchanged with respect to Young's double slit experiment. So, condition for constructive interference was that delta x should be equal to k minus half lambda by 2, and destructive interference, the condition was path difference should be equal to k lambda. Okay. So now let's move on to Fresnel's double mirror.